Good evening. In our last lecture, we have seen how to convert one type of flip flop to another type. We have also seen the different steps that we have followed to convert one type of flip flop to another type. Today, we are going to study about how to convert SR flip flop to JK flip flop. A question may be asked in the examination to convert SR flip flop to JK flip flop for 10 marks. Now, to convert this, the first step is we should know the truth table of SR flip flop and JK flip flop. JK flip flop to understand the behavior of SR and JK flip flop. So in SR flip flop there are two inputs, and this is the output of the next step. For 00 output is no change, given as it is. For 01 the output is 0. For 10 the output is 1. For 11 the output is raise. In case of JK flip flop, the truth table consists of two inputs, J and K, and one output, that is next step, that is Q of N plus 1. For 00, again there is no change, Qn as it is. For 01, the output is 0. For 10, the output is 1. For 11, the output is Qn bar. In the next step, step number 2, we write the excitation tables of both the flip flop, that is SR and JK. So in the excitation table, we have the transition from present state, that is Qn, to Q of N plus 1 if SR. For this, there are four transitions, 0 to 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 0, and 1 to 1. For 0 to 0, the state of SR is 0 plus. For 0 to 1, the state of SR is 1, 0. For 1 to 0, the state of SR is 0, 1. For 1 to 1, the state of SR flip-flop is cross 0. In the excitation table of JK, we have again Qn to Q of N plus 1 transition, that is present state to next state transition, if JK. Again, there are four transitions available, 0 to 0, we write 0 cross, 0 to 1, 1 cross, 1 to 0, cross 1, and 1 to 1 is cross 0. Once we know the truth tables and the excitation tables of both the flip flops, we can easily design the conversion logic table. So we need to design a conversion logic table so that the source flip flop can behave like a target flip flop. In the conversion logic table, there are three columns. The first column is input, second is transition, the third is output. In input column, there is one standard input Qn, and the other inputs of the input column are the inputs of the target flip flop. In transition, we have present state to next state transition, and in the output column, we have the inputs of the source flip flop, that is SR, in our example. For three variables, there are 2 raised to 3 input possibilities, that is 8 input possibilities. So, we will write the binary bits from 0 to 7, that is 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, and 111. So, we got the output column. Now, how to get the transition column? In that, there is present set Qn. We have already drawn a Qn column in the input. So you just copy the Qn column as it is into the transition column. Yeah, Qn. Okay. After that, to get the next state of the transition column, we have to refer the truth table of the JK flip-flop. For JK flip-flop truth table, when JK is 00, the next state output is Qn as it is. So we have to copy 0 as it is. For 0 to 1, the output is, next state output is 0, so we write 0 here. For 1 to 0, the output is 1 in the truth table of JK. When JK is 1, 1, the output is Qn bar, so we need to complement this Qn, and the output is 1 here in the next step. For 0, 0, Qn as it is, we copy 1 as it is here. For 0 to 1, the output of the next state in truth table of JK is 0, so we write 0 here. For 1 to 0, the output is 1, so we write 1 here. For 1 to 1, the output is Qn bar, so we complement this 1 and the next output is 0. Now we got the transition column. Once we have the transition from Qn to Q of N plus 1, we are able to write the values for SR, that is the state of SR flip flop. If you know the transition, you can get the state of SR flip flop. If you see the transition excitation table of SR flip flop, for 0 to 0, there is 0 cross. For 0 to 1, 1 0. For 1 to 0, 0 1. For 1 to 1, the state is cross 0. So we will write as it is into the output column. Now for 0 to 0 transition in SR excitation table, the state of SR is 0 cross. So for the second we will write 0 cross. For 0 to 1, the output in the excitation table is 1 0. So we write it as it is into the last column. That is, for 0 to 1 transition, the output of SR is 1 0. Again, for this also, SR is 1 0. For 1 to 1 transition, the output in the SR is cross 0. So we write for 1 to 1, we write cross 0. For 1 to 0, we have the output 0 1. So we write 0 1. For 1 to 0, it is 0 1. For 1 to 1, again it is cross 0. For 1 to 0, and it is 0 1. So this way we can obtain the output column. Once we get all the columns of this table, we can write the SOP equations for the outputs S and R. In the next step, we obtain the equation SOP equations for the outputs. Here, we can write S equal to summation of minterms. Wherever there is 1 into this column, we collect all those minterms and we put it into the minterms. Plus, wherever there is crosses into this column, that is called as don't care, we put into the don't care in the equation. So, S equal to summation of minterms 2,3 wherever the output is 1. So, for 2,3 the output is 1. So, we write 2,3 plus don't care 4,6. Similarly, we write the output for R. R equal to summation of minterms 5,7 and plus don't care, it is 0 and 1. Once we get the SOP equation, we can easily draw a K-map to simplify that equation. Now this is a 3 variable function, so we have 3 inputs, that is Qn, J and K. So in the K-map we use these input variables and we draw the K-map here, a 3 variable K-map. With the help of the state table, We can design this K-map. Using the output equations, we can design the K-map. See, for cell number 2 and 3, the minterm is 1. For don't care, we have 4,6. Cell number 4,6 are represented by don't care crosses, right? The other cells are filled with logic 0. Now the next task is to loop the logic ones. We have a pair into this K-map. So we form a pair with the help of two ones here, logical ones. And the output for S is nothing but J into Qn bar. If you go vertically, it is J Qn bar. Horizontally, this gets cancelled. So the output for S is J Qn bar. Now see the K-map for R, where 5,7 are the minterms. So 5 and 7 are filled with logic 1. 0 and 1 are crosses that are don't cares into the equation, and remaining cells are filled with logic 0. Now here also we have one pair, a group of two logical one is a pair. So the output for R is, if you go vertically, see just last two columns, third and fourth column, check which is the common variable here, that is Qn, and vertically and horizontally it is K. So the total output is R equals to K Qn. So we got both the equations, that is R and S. Our last step is to design the logic circuit using these equations. Okay. So we write, first of all we draw SR flip flop, the given flip flop, which has two inputs S and R and two outputs Qn and Qn bar. So what is the output of the S? S is J Qn bar, correct? So we have to use an AND gate where one input is J, another input is Qn bar. The output of R is K Qn. So we take another AND gate where one input is K and another input is Qn, and the output is given to R as an input. So this way, we can say that the SR flip-flop gets converted to JK flip-flop. It means that SR flip-flop behaves like a JK flip-flop. So this ends the conversion of SR flip-flop to JK flip-flop. Thank you for watching the video.